United States officially moved its embassy in Israel from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, al-Quds, on Monday.
The most powerful nation on earth, our greatest ally, the United States of America, today its embassy opened here.
It was another one of U.S. President Donald Trump's controversial decisions that drew condemnation from almost the whole world. Trump himself stayed away from the inauguration ceremony amid worldwide opposition. He instead congratulated the relocation on Twitter. The defiant opening of the new U.S. embassy raised regional tensions to new levels with demonstrations against the move held in several countries. Palestinians in the Gaza Strip and the occupied West Bank held anti-occupation protests. Israel's use of lethal force against unarmed protesters in Gaza turned Monday into the bloodiest day for Palestinians since the 2014 Israeli war against the coastal territory. Dozens of Palestinians were killed and hundreds of others injured by Israeli forces on Monday.
We condemn in the strongest term this atrocity by the Israeli occupying forces using this massive firepower against civilians who have the right to demonstrate peacefully, and they have been demonstrating peacefully.
The bloodshed was not even mentioned by top U.S. officials congratulating the relocation.
We've seen that the Palestinians are being sent a clear message that peace doesn't work, that aligning themselves with international law doesn't work. They've tried. They have fought valiantly with peaceful resistance, but have got nowhere. So it's a strong message being sent to the Palestinians that perhaps your only way is to fight them with violence.
Palestinians want Jerusalem al-Quds as the capital of their future state. International law stipulates that the status of the ancient city must be decided through negotiations between the Israelis and the Palestinians. But the May 14th U.S. Embassy relocation was meant to tell the world that America recognizes the city as Israel's capital. The new U.S. Embassy's opening was timed to coincide with the 70th anniversary of the creation of Israel. It was 70 years ago, on May 14th, when Israel was created in Palestine and immediately recognized by the United States. Palestine had been under British colonial control until May that year. Zionist Jews were encouraged by Britain to come to Palestine. The 1948 Israeli Declaration of Independence is widely considered as the starting point for an occupation that has triggered bloody conflicts and impacted the whole Middle East and beyond. Following the foundation of Israel, the forced displacement of Palestinians, known as the Nakba or catastrophe, began. Hundreds of Palestinian villages were destroyed and their residents were forced to flee and were never allowed to return. America's decision to recognize al-Quds as Israel's capital has once again revealed how the U.S. is ready to defy the international community in support of Israel. Over the past decades, the United States has been branding itself as a mediator between the Israelis and the Palestinians.
Our greatest hope is for peace. The United States remains fully committed to facilitating a lasting peace agreement.
But it is widely argued that America's recent decisions regarding the status of Jerusalem al-Quds disqualify the U.S. as a mediator. Meanwhile, Palestinians feel increasingly left alone these days. This is because powerful Arab states in the region seem to be getting increasingly on board with the United States and Israel. Given the latest developments in the region, Palestinians and those truly supporting their cause face an uphill battle.